Levels of measurement is another way of classifying variables. We've previously talked about classification based on qualitative or quantitative, as well as discrete and continuous. Levels of measure is a little different. It classifies variables based on the nature of the information they contain. Before we classify variables based on one of the four levels of measurement, it will help to know if the data is qualitative or quantitative. This is useful because each level of measure only applies to one of those variable types. Qualitative variables, or those without numeric meaning, can only be nominal or ordinal. Nominal data is set up so it has no order or ranking, while ordinal data has an implied order or ranking. For example, nominal data classifies variables into different categories, but there's no standard order or implied ranking to these categories, such as what is your hair color, or political party, or favorite food, what pair of shoes are you wearing right now based on brand. While these may have numeric codes, such as 1 for Nike, 2 for Adidas, etc., these numbers have no numeric meaning or ranking. It's not to say that Nikes are more popular than Adidas. It's just a random numeric identification code, usually done for analysis purposes. Whereas ordinal data has ranking or order, such as rate your satisfaction. Are you a faster or slower runner? One would rank higher than the other. What is your highest level of education, ranking from some high school all the way up to a terminal degree? This ranking creates order or ordinal data. Quantitative data, on the other hand, data that has numeric meaning, can be classified as interval or ratio. Interval data has a meaningful interval between the data points, however, not an absolute zero and no meaningful ratio. Ratio data has an absolute zero and the ratio between data points is also meaningful. Let's take a look at what that means. When we look at interval data, think about the temperature outside, Celsius or Fahrenheit. The interval between the temperature points is important. 20 to 30 degrees is a 10 degree shift. However, the units make a difference here. A 10 degree shift in Celsius is not the same as a 10 degree shift in Fahrenheit. And the ratio is not important. To say it's 40 degrees out does not mean it's twice as warm as when it's 20 degrees out. It merely means there's a 20 degree difference. The zero in this case is also not absolute. 0 degrees Celsius or Fahrenheit does not mean complete lack of heat. It's merely a placeholder between the negative temperatures and the positive. And again, 0 degrees Celsius has different meaning than 0 degrees Fahrenheit. They are not the same zero. They don't mean nothing, or it is not absolute. In contrast, ratio data, such as weight, cost, height, and bank account balance, do have a meaningful absolute zero. For example, I have 0 ounces of oranges in my home right now. Nothing. You won't find any. Now, many people confuse the idea of absolute zero with the idea that, is this possible? Is it possible to have a dog that weighs 0 pounds? Well, no, it's not possible to have a 0-pound dog. That dog would not exist. However, the idea of weight, or the unit we measure weight in, a zero is possible. Take this outside of the context of what you're measuring and look at just the unit alone. Pounds, ounces, kilograms, grams. Zero is possible for all of those units, and it means nothing, nada. No matter what unit you're measuring in, it is absolutely zero. In this case, the ratio is also important. For example, if I go out to purchase a television and I find 2 options, one is $400 and one is $200, the ratio, or the division of these two, results in the number 2. the first television is twice as expensive as the second. The ratio has meaning. It gives us a comparison point. Ratio data has a meaningful ratio and an absolute zero. Now that we've explored the four different measurement levels, nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio, I'm going to let you try it out. Test it out. We're going to visit a local half marathon. There I am. Just finished the run, actually, and look at four variables that were collected based on that day. The temperature on the day of the race, your age on race day in years, your randomly assigned race or bib number, and your age group classification, teen, adult, masters, or veteran. Take a moment and test yourself out. See if you can classify these. Hint, there is one of each variable. All right, let's go ahead and take a look. The temperature, which honestly is one of the most prevalent examples of interval data, is interval in nature. No meaningful zero and no meaningful ratio. It is quantitative, so I know it must be interval or ratio, and I encourage you to first classify your data as quantitative or qualitative, as that will help you instantly narrow down your choices. Your age on race day. This does have a meaningful zero. 0 years means zero, nothing. It does not mean I am running a half marathon at the age of zero or that zero is possible. It just means that it does mean nothing or absolutely zero. As a result, this is ratio in nature. Your randomly assigned bib number. It is just a code or identification value. It does not tell anything about you other than to ID you, and it has no implied ranking, making this nominal. Your age group on race day is ranked from youngest, teen, to oldest, veteran. Therefore, this is ordinal. With a little practice, I'm sure you'll be classifying variables like a champ.